evening, and welcome to the Theatre Fever Spooktacular, presented by AAT. Me name's Tom.
And I'm Tom.
And welcome to the Fright House. So you must be the new light keeps, eh?
Oh, I think you mean fright keeps. Boom!
We're so glad you could join us for this six-week all-expenses-paid vacation courtesy of King Triton himself.
Whether you're an experienced Wiki or a new baby gold, this week is going to be full of creepy crawlers and ghastly ghouls.
Milk! But before you get going anywhere, there's a few things you need to know about being a lightkeeper. Tom, get the book.
Aye, aye, Captain.
In this book lay the ancient secrets all about how to keep a lighthouse.
The rules in this book are very, very important, and you mustn't forget them.
Shut up, Sammy!
All right, Tom! That's the first rule! Bad luck to kill a seabird!
Even though how annoying they may be.
Oh, Sammy never hurt no one! On with the show!
Too much to mention. Was I really really seeking good or just seeking attention? Is that all good deeds are when looked at with an ice cold eye? If that's all good deeds are, maybe that's the reason why. No good deed goes unpunished. All helpful urges should be circumvented. No good deed goes unpunished. Sure, I meant well. Well, look at what well meant did. All right, enough. So be it. So be it then. Let all odds be agreed. I'm wicked through and through, since I cannot succeed. Fiero saving you, I promise no good deed will I attempt to do again, ever again. No good deed will I do again.
And the same thing happens every time, where I get interrupted because someone wants to go get a sandwich, or I'm crying and they start laughing at me, or there's tons of people out in the lobby who are just like me, except they're prettier and they're better at everything. Because maybe I'm not good enough. Maybe I'm one of those people that have always wanted to do it, but it's like a pipe dream, you know? Then you've said it. You've admitted it. So now it's time to change your dreams and to grow up. Maybe I'm one of those people and it's just not gonna work. Because I moved out here and to do that. And it's been 6 years and I just can't do it anymore. It hurts too much to keep trying.
Down. Life's losing my mind, losing control.
Thank you.
welcome back. I hope your first week went well. It certainly took me a while to adjust. Do you have any questions thus far?
Yeah, I got one.
Oh, Sammy, what now?
Oh, come on, man. Just one joke. Just one joke.
Sammy, I am not going to put in a good word so you can be in the Theatre Fever Spooktacular presented by AAT.
Oh, come on, man. I've really been working out my routine. It's really good, man. You'll love it. I promise.
There's already too many people as is, and they're not going to have a bird in it.
Oh, it's a fast joke. It's a fast joke. It's a real quick one, you know?
Fine, make it quick.
All right. Okay. What's the best place to get Italian food in the ocean?
Where, Sammy?
The Marinara Trench! Hey-oh! Come on, folks. Come on, these jokes write themselves. All right, one more. One more. Come on, Tommy.
You gotta go,
Sammy. One more. The people love it. All right. What's the difference between the ocean and the Kardashians?
Sammy, I don't care.
There's less plastic in the ocean! Hey-oh! Come on, folks. Come on. Oh, you want more? Oh, they want some more.
All
right, where does a fish go for a loan? The prawn broker. What's a shrimp's favorite bond flick?
I really don't care, man.
License to krill. What happened to the shark that swallowed all the keys? What happened to the shark that swallowed all the keys, Tommy?
You gotta go! This was you? Bad luck to kill a seabird, Tommy. Back to the show!
Children are more perceptive. They see things that adults can't. They're not yet tethered to only accepting what society wants them to accept. They see what's truly there. They see the monsters. If you were to borrow a child's eyes for a night, you would go insane. Being able to see what you only dimly remember. Burrowing under the covers while wearing those train pajamas and desperately praying to a god that you can barely comprehend, that it doesn't see you back. would drive an adult crazy. Because adults forget the rules. One, cover yourself. If you can't see it, it can't see you. Even if it makes it harder to breathe. Two, don't make a noise. Every whimper can lead to your destruction. Three, don't move. It attracts their attention. And four, only light can make it go away. Bright light. Flashlights only make it worse. Teens are caught in the middle. They can still feel what's there, but they can't see, and they forget the rules. Why do you think that there are so many insomniacs sitting at their computers, typing away, and praying that the light from the monitor is enough to keep them away? It's not. Now look behind you with a child's eyes. And try not to scream.
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. But now he's dear and so unsure, I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
Singing along in the background again.
No, Flounder was being a guppy and decided to stay home. It's something else.
Oh, yes, I suppose you're right.
Is it?
Yes. Indeed it is.
Well, you know what that means.
Strange in a neighborhood. Don't you wanna feel those shivering fits till someone calls and quits or someone calls a cop? Don't you wanna land the role of a lifetime? Well, you better get down on one knee, 'cause you can play the life of the party. You can pray with me. The top of the heap. This is where the tambourine never ends. Why not be counting friends instead of counting sheep? If you want to join the heavenly choir, hurry up and get yourself in line. But don't you pass the life of the party until you pass the wine. Let the drinks pour, let the crowds roar, let the heavens wildly cheer till the sunrise brings the goodbyes. I'll be here, never fear. Oh, how's it gonna be? The life of the party. How's it gonna be? The king of the
Tommy?
Shut up, Jake.
And we're back! are so glad to see you again. But now that you're back, it's probably time Tommy tell you rule number two.
But, see, we're technically not allowed to go. See, we're technically not allowed. You good?
Huh?
What?
On with it then.
Well, see, we're not allowed to...
The lighthouse is mine, you see? The light is mine. Nobody goes up there. It's me. The light's mine.
Tom, we have company.
Did you tell them the rules?
I did.
Ah, oh, good. Back to the show.
So I followed him up the beach. Then he stopped and said I could wear the medal all day if I gave him 50 cents.
Rhoda! Stop that! Is that the truth?
Yes, Mother. I gave him 50 cents and he let me wear the medal.
Then why didn't you tell this to Miss Fern when she questioned you?
Oh, Mommy. Mommy, Miss Fern doesn't like me at all. I was scared she'd think bad things about me if I told her I had the medal.
You knew how much Mrs. Daggle wanted that medal. Didn't you?
Yes, I guess so.
No, you don't know what I mean.
But it was silly to want to bury the medal pinned on Claude's coat. Claude was dead. He wouldn't know whether he had the medal pinned on him or not. I've got the sweetest mother. That's what I tell everybody. I say I've got the sweetest mother in the whole world. If she wants a little boy that bad, why isn't she taking one of the orphans home?
Rhoda! Get away from me. Don't talk to me. We have nothing to say to each other.
Okay, Mother.
Rhoda! Did you have anything to do at all, no matter how little it was, with Claude being drowned?
What makes you ask that, Mother?
Rhoda, come here and look me in the eyes. I must know the truth.
No, Mother, I didn't.
You're not going back to the Fern School next year. They don't want you anymore.
Okay.
I'll call Miss Fern and tell her what she told me.
She'll think I lied to her.
You did lie to her.
But not to you, Mother. Not to you.
Hello, Fern School. Miss Claudia Fern, please. No, no message. She's not at home. What are you doing?
Nothing.
Is that for the incinerator?
Yes.
What is it?
Just some things you told me to throw away.
Let me see the package.
No.
Let me see it!
Oh, put it back! It's mine! It's mine!
You hit him with the shoe. Didn't you? That's how those half moon marks got on his forehead and hands. Isn't it? Answer me! Answer me!
I hit him with the shoes! I had to hit him with the shoes, Mother! What else could I do?
Do you realize you murdered him?
It was his fault. If he'd given me the medal like I told him to, I wouldn't have had to hit him.
Tell me what happened. Start from the beginning. I know you killed him. There's no point in lying anymore.
I can't.
Rhoda, I love you! I'm waiting for my answer.
He wouldn't give me the medal like I told him to. That's all. So when he ran away down the wharf, I followed him. I told him I'd hit him with my shoe if he didn't give me the medal. He shook his head and said no, so I hit him the first time. Then he took off the medal and gave it to me and...
What happened then?
Well, he tried to run away, so I hit him again. And he was crying and making noises, and I was scared somebody would hear him. So I hit him again. I hit him harder this time, and he fell into the water. What are we gonna do? I've got the nicest mother. That's what I tell everybody. I say I've got the sweetest, the nicest.
Rhoda, how did the bruises get on the back of his hands?
Well, he tried to pull himself back on the wharf after he fell into the water. I wouldn't have him anymore, only he said he was going to tell on me. Mommy, please say you won't let them hurt me.
I don't know what we must do now, but I promise, nobody will hurt you.
Mommy, if I give you a basket of kisses, what will you give me?
Rhoda, just...
Can't you give me an answer? If I give you a basket of kisses, what will you
give
me?
Rhoda! Go to your room and read. I must think on what to do. Promise me you won't tell anyone what you just told me.
Why would I tell anyone and get killed?
Now here you go again, you say you want your
I'm unfamiliar with this part. I am a stranger here myself. Why is it wrong to murmur I adore him when it's shamefully obvious I do? Does love embarrass him or does it bore him? I'm only waiting for my cue. I am a stranger here myself. I dream of a day, of a gay old day, with my face between his hands. Have I missed the path? Have I gone astray? I ask and no one understands. Love me or leave me, that seems to be the question. I don't know which tactics to use, but if he should offer a personal suggestion, how could I possibly refuse when I'm a stranger here myself? Please tell a stranger, my curiosity loaded, is there really any danger that love is now outmoded? I'm interested especially in knowing why you waste it. True romance is so freshly, with what have you replaced it? What is your latest foible? Is gin rummy more exquisite? Is skiing more enjoyable? For heaven's sakes, what is it? I can't believe that love has lost its glamour, that passion is really passé. If gender is just a term in grammar, how can I ever find my way when I'm a stranger here myself? How can he ignore my available condition? Why these Victorian views? You see here before you a woman with a mission. I must discover the key to his ignition. And then if he should make a diplomatic proposition, how could I possibly refuse? How could I possibly refuse when I'm a stranger here myself?
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
How do you feel, Andy?
Well, I'm afraid of heights, so I'm as ready as I'll ever be. Hi, my name is Andy Nish.
And my name is Stephanie Cerros.
And we are here at the historic Wendover Airfield, ghost hunting.
So our first stop is the control tower. We're gonna go ahead and climb up there in just a little bit. Are you ready, Jake?
No.
This is our wonderful cameraman, Jacob Watts.
Hi.
How do you feel, big guy?
You know, I'm just terrified to be here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, it's gonna get a lot worse, buddy.
No. Don't say that.
So, we're just leaving the air traffic control tower, and I don't know if we actually saw something. I feel like we did.
Either way, we're just going to go ahead and move on.
Yeah, because we're both afraid of heights. So,
next, we're going to hit up that abandoned airplane over here.
Yay!
Let's go. So, technically it says no trespassing, but there's no cops, so.
Let's have a field day.
Hell yeah.
How you feel, big guy?
I, you know, just shaking my boots.
Yeah, it's all right. What about you?
I feel fine. That last control tower, well, that thing we saw was kind of creepy, but...
I don't know. All right.
Maybe it's just the shadows.
All right, shall we?
Hey,
Jake, you want to go first?
Don't even joke about it.
All right, I'll go first. Here, I'll give you the light so you can actually see me.
So there's literally nothing in here.
Except for your cockpit.
Andy, do you want to go in the cockpit?
Sure.
Oh. Oh my god, the camera's... Ah.
No. Hey, Jake, get back here.
No.
We're in this together, buddy.
Right. It's literally probably just the wind.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, because we just know
No.
Did you move the steering wheel?
No, I didn't even get in there.
I don't believe you.
Oh, there's nothing in here. We're good.
Just the steering wheel?
Yeah, I think it was the wind.
There's nothing in there. What is this?
Dude, there's nothing in here. One of the windows is broken out, so it probably spun the wheel.
Then you threw this, because either you threw it or someone else is in there.
I didn't throw it. No.
You guys, it's literally probably just the wind.
No, that's what I said.
Okay. Well, either way, I'm kind of spooked out, so let's go.
Okay.
This was, according to the map, it was opened some time ago, but now it looks like it has been...
abandoned and boarded up.
Yeah.
But...
only for a reason.
There is a broken window right here, so we can see in. Oh, no. Nope.
What?
No, nope.
That's really creepy, actually.
Is that a crib?
Nope.
Like, dead ass, nope.
Dude, that's a straight up crib.
It's a play place.
That's a child's play place.
Oh, my heavens.
That's.
No,
I don't want it.
No, I don't want it.
That was super creepy, exit path.
Oh, there's another hole.
Hey, Jake, see if you're tall. Take this flashlight so you can get any good shots in there. Here, take it.
I got one in my hand.
There you go.
I don't want to look, though.
Yeah, what's in there? I can't see. We're too short. What's in there?
I don't see anything so far.
Okay.
Fuck you.
Bar and classroom. There's some desks, and then there's a mattress and a, like an old hallway down there. I can't see.
What
anything.
The hell is that?
Do you guys hear that? Let's go. Let's move.
No,
let's
no,
move.
Wait, no, I'm serious. Did you do that?
Did I do what? Did I throw it? No. Dude, I had the flashlight in my hand the whole time.
Okay, all right, I believe you.
All right.
Let's just go. This is creepy. All
right, what's down here?
We gotta go now. All right. There's someone.
Shit, what?
Dude, there's someone here.
What?
Oh my God. Okay,
I saw him, I kid you not.
So,
nope.
Here, why don't you take the camera for a moment? We're just gonna go on the opposite side of the base because we think we saw someone, but we're not sure.
No, we saw someone.
Jake has...
He's left. He's not with us right now. He was too scared, so he's sitting in the car. But me and Stephanie did find this building that, you know, I think we're probably gonna be able to get into. It doesn't have any boards on it. There's no locks.
Okay.
What
the actual fuck?
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Let's go.
Alright.
Yeah.
Are you sure you want to go in here?
Hey, you brought me out here for a reason. Let's get this done.
Okay. Let's just go.
Yeah.
This will be like the last building. Is that cool?
Yeah, that's fine. Absolutely.
What the?
Touch your stuff.
Oh my god, that's like a literal hole.
Yeah, watch your stuff. That makes me feel better. Direct TV box. Yeah, I
just leave after this one?
Yeah, I guess. Ah! Fuck, dog, free camera.